get this gas tank off and change this plug. Disconnect that fuel line again. So I'm going to go ahead and put this back in neutral. And set the parking brake. And let's get this tank off of here. Oh, I need to get this back off of here too. The only downfall of these bikes, you gotta change the spark plug. It's not like it's easily accessible. We'll just slide this out. And let's take the plug. I'm guessing that's original. I need to blow that out before I pull that plug out. Let's go ahead and do that now. Well, it's always a good idea to blow this thing out because you never know what's in there. So I just kind of go through the hole here. Stuff falling down in there. Just make sure it's good and clean. Looks alright. And spark plug. Yep. And as always, they never want to come out because I don't have a little or thick enough rubber grommet in the thing, so I can resort to needle nose. Oh, looks like it's running good. Little pro CR70. Do I have a CR? I do. I have one CR70 sitting here. And it is new. And let's go ahead and gap it. Usually go like 2.8. All right, so let's get a plug in there. What did I do with it? There it is. Alright, and we'll just make sure this spins over. Put the cover back on. Time to get these back on there, so go ahead and get these put back on. That one goes there, and the other one is right here. That'll just go over this. Like so, and then we can get the gas tank back in there. Lined up. Two tank bolts, get those put back in. And get the vacuum lines back on, and we'll get the fuel line put back in. Come on. I think that is it. I'll get this snorkel back on there. You guys, do not use this. Your bike will run kind of awful because it's allowing too much air in there. I mean, you can see it basically cuts it in half rather than just having an open in there. So if you guys are working on your bike and you do have this off, it will cause problems, guaranteed. If you have it rejetted for without it, then you should be fine. But if you have stock jets, then it will require this to be put back on. And then this one goes through here. And just gets run back out. All right. I think I'm at the point where I'm gonna put some fluids in it and hook the battery up. Hopefully the battery works. If not, I'll pull one out of my bike. I have a couple batteries here that I could try, so we'll see what happens and kind of go from there. So let's get some fluids in here. Go ahead and raise it back up.
All right, we need oil and we need coolant. So let's get that taken care of. And I will come back with you guys when I'm ready to start this thing up, but I don't think you guys want to hang out just watching me add oil and coolant, so stand by. All right, fluids are in it. Let me hook up a battery. Kind of curious if the original battery worked or will work. But let's see. Let's see what happens with the original battery. I'm just going to go ahead and stick it up here for now. And I'm just using water now. That way, if there's any leaks, I can address that. And I'm just going to go ahead and temporarily hook this battery up here before I put the plastics back in and find a little battery terminal squares. Let's go ahead and use these. And get this positive hooked up. This battery's got like this little thing on here. I honestly don't even know if it works, so. Get one of these in there. Here's the moment of truth. Let's see if this bike truly does run. I'm gonna be pissed if it's more than what I got into it right now. But, like I said, those are the chances you take. So let's hook this back up. Reach, nope. Let's just go ahead and set this battery down on this one down here. That's going to be the next best place for it. Where did that little square go for the battery? There it is. Down here. Probably not my luck. No. I guess I could just bring it back up here. Yeah, I'll just do it this way. As I don't know, this battery's good. Find out here in a second. All right. Truth. Let's see if this pig runs. No power, that's a good sign. This parking brake's gonna need to be adjusted. That battery's gonna have enough juice. I'm gonna say no. So now, let's see what other battery we got that I can use. Because that one's not gonna cut it. This is where I just keep putting stuff down and losing my mind. All right, so I'm gonna have to probably order a battery. Let's see if we can find a battery just to get this thing started. As this one obviously is not gonna cut it. Get me by so I can get a new battery coming. I'll probably have to order one of those up tonight. So this one is junk. That one can go up here. I do have that one, this one. Let's go for this one. This one will work. One doesn't need these. It just needs the screws. Posts are all different. This is ridiculous. Got one more after this. If not, we'll order the battery. See what happens here. So it looks a little more promising.
Thank you. good now. Had a little mishap with the carb. Guys, don't cheap out on the carb kits. I ended up pulling the car back off and putting some of the old parts back in. I definitely recommend a higher quality carb kit. It was just dumping fuel out the back of the overflow hose. So I pulled it apart and replaced some parts back from the original ones, and it seems to be running good now. Kicks on, and I just got water in the coolant for now, that way I can check for leaks rather than wasting coolant if there is a leak. So we'll let that kick on, and then we'll kind of go from there. So hopefully the fan will kick on, all goes well. But oil is good, check that. Running good. This kind of scared me when I saw that fuel down there. I thought it was oil. And I was like, why is this thing leaking oil? And then I smelled it. It was definitely fuel. So we'll see how long it takes for that fan to kick on. Happened there. That is weird. That should not have happened. Let's go see what's going on. Oh, I got it on. I probably ran out of fuel on the top level. Fuel started pouring out of there again. Definitely think we got a carb issue. So I'm sitting here, and as it's running, the fuel started pouring out there again. I don't know why. I'm gonna let this thing down and kind of see if I got enough fuel in there, but it's just kind of weird that it does that. So I got another carb kit on the way, a high caliber one, a better quality one. I kind of thought I got this taken care of, but obviously not. So back to square one with the carb. Let's go ahead and let this down. I'll have to see what's going on with this carb. It should not be doing this. Let me check the fuel. I'll see how much fuel we got here. Uh, I didn't put a whole lot in there for fear that, you know, something might go wrong or whatever. And I got plenty for reserve. I am on reserve now. I don't know if this is a fluke, because when I switch it over, it goes past prime. So let's see what happens again. Set you guys up down here. You guys can get a better look at what's going on here. Filling up a fuel too much.